a votary of truth. Indian Freedom Struggle and Dr. S. Srikanta Sastri. Dr. S. Srikanta Sastri lived in the house of one Elandur Gopal Sastri, father of Y.G. Krishnamurti, on Disubaya Road. Y.G. Krishnamurti was a handsome young man, blessed with talent. In fact, he was a multifaceted person who later became a prominent freedom fighter. Y.G. Krishnamurti was born in 1911 and he joined Maharaja College in 1935 to do an undergraduate course in history and English literature. He soon became a star debater in student union competitions in English and Kannada. He wrote poems in English, which were appreciated by Professor J.C. Rolo, principal of the college, and Professor B.M. Srikantaya. He participated in various student agitations against the British rule, and often it was led by him. He was arrested on many occasions and jailed. Under the inspiration of Dr. S. Srikanta Sastri, he began to write books criticizing the British rule. Some of the important books written by Y.G. Krishnamurti: Indian States and the Federal Plan, 1939, Independent India and a New World Order, 1943, Constituent Assembly and Indian Federation, 1940, Jawaharlal Nehru, The Man and His Ideas, and Gandhiism for Millions, 1942. Srikanta Sastri over Berlin radio during Second World War. In fact, Dr. S. Srikanta Sastri wrote several introductions and forewords to several of these volumes written by Y.G. Krishnamurti. In 1943, in a radio broadcast from Berlin, the book Independent India and a New World Order was discussed during a program. In this book review, the foreword written by S. Srikanta Sastri was discussed. This caused quite a lot of stir in Mysore, and S. Srikanta Sastri was arrested and interrogated by the British secret police. Y.G. Krishnamurti was in touch with such national leaders as Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, S. Radhakrishnan, Krishnahati Singh, Bulabhai Desai, and Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Nehru sent his Discovery of India, first signet edition, 1946, to S. Srikanta Sastri for his opinion and review. Y.G. Krishnamurti went on to receive the highest award from King Mahendra of Nepal, given to a foreigner, Gorkha Dakshin Bahu II, later. Y.G.K. lived in Nepal and wrote several books. His biography of King Mahendra is quite well known. Around 1943, S. Srikanta Sastri wrote Geopolitics of India and Greater India, which came to be published only in 1994. At that time, Karl Haushofer was harping on geopolitics, and it was later used by Adolf Hitler in justifying the occupation of Austria, Hungary, Belgium and France. Dr. Srikanta Sastri was the first Indian historian to pay attention to the new field of geopolitics, which is today an established field of study.
Professor Sastri wrote on geopolitics. What is geopolitics? It is something totally different subject. It is of a European origin. It is a modern subject. So Dr. Srikanta Sastri, Sundekappa Srikanta Sastri, who writes on Indian culture, who writes on Kannada language, literature, Telugu language, he was also guiding paper on Telugu language. He could mention all Telugu scholars and their contributions. Such a person who was immersed in ancient culture, think of geopolitics, which is a modern subject. How can you do it? Geopolitics is an objective study of politico-geographical factors. It is a study of power and politics, speculations, political speculations. The term geopolitics was coined shortly before the First World War and spread throughout Europe between two World Wars and came into worldwide use during the Second World War.
Yes, Srikanta Sastri had the courage of conviction to write an article with the title, Is the Maharaja of Mysore a True Sovereign? While teaching at Maharaja College, affiliated to University of Mysore, whose chancellor was Maharaja Nalvadi Krishna Rajavadiyar IV. It irked Diwan Mirza Ismail greatly to read this anti-royal but nonetheless factual article. The British regent was supreme in the princely state of Mysore at that time. The Diwan summoned Srikanta Sastri and gave a dressing down with the final warning that Maharaja had the powers to hang him. Srikanta Sastri stood his ground firmly and told the Diwan that sovereignty rested with the British paramount power. He boldly told the Diwan, Mysore has no sovereignty and Mysore is a created state. If the Maharaja has the powers to hang me, let him exercise it. And so saying, he then walked out. In 1938, Congress Party conducted its annual session at Haripura. It turned out to be a historic Congress session because Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose got elected by defeating the conscience candidate of Mahatma Gandhi, Sri Pattabhi Sitaramaya. 11 out of 12 working committee members, at the behest of Gandhi, resigned, and Nehru was the sole exception. Only Jawaharlal Nehru pretended to support Bose but continued his arm twisting. A frustrated Subhash Chandra Bose resigned from his post and also gave up the primary membership of the Congress Party. After the parting of ways, Bose started a new political party called Forward Bloc. The Haripur Congress Souvenir was edited by Y.G. Krishnamurti. Yes, Srikanta Sastri contributed an important article, The History of the Congress Polity, anonymously. The souvenir also carries a message from President Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose.